This video is all about converting files like PDFs, Word documents, and more into clean Markdown, without relying on online tools, without giving away your data, and with no need to be a developer. By the end of this video, you will know exactly how to convert a wide range of files like PDFs, Word, HTML pages, and even EPUBs, so ebooks, into clean Markdown. We will take a closer look at some of these formats in a moment. You will be able to do it locally, without relying on online converters or exposing sensitive documents to third-party services. That means your data stays on your machine, where it belongs. We will start a desktop application I built so anyone can use it, even without touching Python, GitHub, or the command line. It is designed to be as simple and accessible as possible, or at least as I could make it. Then we will move on to a script I wrote that batch processes entire folders. This is great if you have dozens or even hundreds of files to convert in one go. All this is based on the official Microsoft GitHub project MarkItDown. This gives us a solid, no-frills way to convert individual files using the command line interface. Use the chapters and timestamps in the description to navigate to your preferred solution. Right now, we look at the simple app for batch converting files into Markdown. At the core of the app is a Python script. And if you watched some of my videos, you will know by now that I'm not a developer. But even before I started working on this video, I decided to look at Python and took a class on Skillshare, the sponsor of today's video. Among the multitude of classes, there are many that can help you learn how to code in different programming languages, or even how to use AI for development, including Python. Obviously, I still do not think of myself as a developer, but my overall understanding of programming logic and particularly the Python syntax certainly improved a lot after this class. And if you could not care less about programming, you will definitely find other interesting topics on Skillshare, from AI to photography and productivity, and pretty much anything in between. If you're more interested in topics like systems thinking, digital workflows, or building a second brain, there are plenty of productivity-focused classes too, covering everything from time blocking and creative routines to mastering tools that help you think clearer and move faster. To make your decision easier, here's a fantastic offer from Skillshare for you. The first 500 people to use the link in the description get a 20% discount off their first year on Skillshare. And additionally, the first 7 days are completely free. And you will also have a 30-day money-back guarantee. With that, you get all the benefits at zero risk and can safely join the largest online learning community for creatives and benefit from their learning by doing approach when submitting your own project and getting feedback on it. Let's start with the easiest option, using the Lean Productivity Markdown Bulk Converter. Yep, it's a bit of a bulky name, but it describes what it does. First, we download the app, run the installer, and launch it just like any other Windows program. Please note that the downloadable file and the installer are not certified. So you might get a warning in your browser when downloading it or on your PC when running it. If I wanted to get rid of this, I would have to pay almost 250 euro per year for a certificate. That's not something I can afford to do. So if you don't trust me, you can jump to the next chapter where I show you how to do everything manually with GitHub repositories, a command line interface, and full control over what's happening on your device. However, if you do trust me, let's install it and see how it works. Once it's running, we get a simple interface. Let me walk you through what everything does. First, we choose the input folder. I have prepared a folder with demo files in different formats so we can test it properly. If you want to use those, you can download them via the link in the description. Next, we set the output folder. This is where we will save the converted Markdown files. If our input folder has subfolders, then the output folder will mirror those, allowing us to convert files and maintain the folder structure. Below that, we can select which file types we want to convert. The app supports a wide variety of documents. We can use it for the most common Office formats, such as Microsoft Word, Excel, and PowerPoint. It also works with PDF, HTML, and EPUB files, and media formats like images, audio, and video. You can find the full list in the documentation of the GitHub repository. First, we will do a dry run with all the file types selected. This simulates the conversion without actually creating Markdown files. very useful to see what the tool would do. The app gives us a summary of how many files are in the selection, how many would be new conversions, overwritten, or skipped because the source file has not changed since the last conversion. Now let's narrow it down and try run only the DOCX files. Again, we are not converting any files just yet. We are only previewing what will happen if we trigger the actual conversion. Before we convert anything, let's look at one of the source files. This is one of the test documents in its native format. As you can see, we have a few headings, some text, and even a table in here. Back in the application, we still see the dry run summary and can decide to start the actual conversion. This generates new Markdown files in the output folder. As mentioned earlier, the app also creates folders if they don't exist yet. And this is the converted Markdown version of the Word document we saw earlier. We can see the Markdown formatting for the headings and the table is also there. Although this requires some fixing. As you can see, it preserves the formatting and it's ready to use in any Markdown-based system like Obsidian. If we enable logging, the application also creates a detailed log file of everything we did. Helpful for checking each file status, which could be cumbersome if the conversion included many files. Let's add the JSON file type and run the conversion again. The summary shows us that a total of 4 files is affected, but only one will be converted because the 3 DOCX files from the previous run are the same and therefore the application skipped those. Now let's make a small change to the original file and run a dry run again. Because the timestamp has changed, it will flag this file as needing conversion while skipping the others. Before we check that, let's select a few more formats to test batch conversion with mixed file types. Because we're careful, we keep dry run enabled and can see the queued files without modifying anything. If you're happy with the summary of the dry run, we just confirm that we want to do the actual conversion. Here is the updated log file, showing the outcome per file. We can see which files are new, overwritten, or have been skipped. If we want to convert unchanged files, we can select Force Convert All Files. Normally, the application skips files it thinks haven't changed based on their timestamps. But with this box checked, it processes everything regardless of timestamps. Now we will do a last run. All supported formats, force conversion disabled, logging enabled, and with a dry run first. We check the summary, click OK, and yes to start the actual conversion. We can see the conversion progress and, at the end, a summary of what the application did. We can also view the log file to make sure everything is okay. And here are the results. Clean Markdown files from PDFs, HTML, Word, JSON, and more. It has to be said that some of these converted files will require a bit of fixing. For example, it does not always interpret formatting in PDFs correctly, and Markdown tables can be a bit weird too. But overall, this is still much faster than doing it manually, and safer than doing it with an online tool. So that's the beginner-friendly way to convert files into Markdown. It's quick, it's safe, and it is local. Let's move on to the more technical method. Now let's look at the more technical option, using the original open source MarkItDown project by Microsoft. This version gives us full control, but requires several steps to set it up. We will need to install the Git client, the latest version of Python, and if it's not installed automatically with Python, pip. You will find links to all these websites in the description. From here on out, I will assume that they are installed. If you're not sure, use these commands in a terminal or a PowerShell window to check the presence of all 3. Then we head over to the official MarkItDown repository page on GitHub, where we find a README file with setup instructions. To get the files locally, we run git clone followed by the repository's URL. Here we have 2 options. If you already have an SSH key, we can use this method. If not, we can use the HTTPS version of the command, like so, the result will be the same. This creates a directory called MarkItDown with a local copy of the project on our machine. Once cloned, we enter the folder to set up our virtual environment with Python. We type python-m venv.mid, where .mid is the name of our virtual environment. Then activate it with scripts/activate. This helps isolate our dependencies from the rest of the system. Now we install the required Python packages using pip, and we can also install specific packages if we only need to convert certain file types, but for this video, we install them all. Let's do a basic test. we will use the command line interface, our terminal window, to convert a single .docx file. We still have our demo files under input/demo files. So we can enter the command markitdown, followed by the path and name of the source file, and a greater than sign, followed by the path and name of the converted markdown file as output. Once it's done, we can find the new file in the specified location, and if we open it, we see it is indeed the markdown version of our Word document. Here we can see both the original Word document and the new markdown version. The converted markdown keeps headers, paragraphs, and basic formatting. As mentioned before, we may need to fine-tune some formatting, especially for tables or special characters. So that's the setup using the raw markitdown project. It's a bit more work upfront, but offers full transparency and control. I also have something that maintains this control while adding the option to do bulk conversions. Follow me. If we want to keep control of what is happening by using the GitHub project and want to convert multiple files at once, we can use a simple Python script. This is basically a minimal version of what I'm using in the application, but still command line based without a graphical user interface. The script has the same core functionality as the previously shown application, but no graphical user interface, and it lacks some of the more advanced features. Things like selecting the input and output folders, a progress bar, log file generation, override warnings, and, important if you have a lot of files, parallel processing are missing from this script. If you want to benefit from those features, you will have to use the application. The requirements for running it are the same as before. We need Python, a local clone of the GitHub project, and to activate our virtual environment. Once we have that, we can execute the script in our terminal window via the command Python followed by the script's name. Then, instead of asking for a specific file, the script prompts for files to be converted, or rather file types. We can enter a single one, like docx, or multiple values separated by commas. Let's take docx, HTML, and PDF as an example. When the conversion completes, we get a summary in our terminal window. How many files were converted, skipped, or had errors? Contrary to the application, we see the results directly in the terminal window instead of in a separate log file. Just like before, we get clean markdown, and it also preserves the folder structure. But we do not have the option to do a dry run first or force files to be overwritten. So if you're comfortable with the terminal and want more automation than the one file option allows, this script gives you that middle ground. Full control, but no need to repeat commands manually for each file. We have seen three different ways to convert files into Markdown. Let's take a step back and compare them side by side. The application is the easiest to use. We don't need any technical skills beyond downloading the setup file and installing it. Remember that you might get a warning because I'm not paying for a certificate confirming that the application is mine and clean. So it also requires a bit of trust on your behalf. The application can also handle parallel processing. It is easy to use and creates detailed log files. The Python script gives us more control while still being accessible if you're okay with the terminal. It's great for large conversions and, if you know your way around Python, you can easily customize it. And the original Markdown project? Well, this is best used if you have only a handful of files to convert and don't need any logging. You can jump back to any chapter using the timestamps in the description if you want to revisit one of the methods. So, whether you are a no-code beginner, a curious power user, or a command line ninja, there is a method that fits your style. Choose the one that works best for your workflow and let Markdown do the rest. You will find all the links in the description, including downloads, GitHub, and demo files. If this video helped you, give it a thumbs up. Consider subscribing and let me know in the comments how you are using Markdown. And if you want more tutorials like this, just say so. If I can, I will make it happen. In the meantime, why not watch this video next? I'm sure it can be of interest to you. And that's it for today. Thanks for watching and see you next time.